Hi, I'm John Riley here at the Memphis Drum Shop, and I brought a collection of old K Zildjian cymbals with me today, and I'd like to talk about them because people are still curious about them and there's some mystery involved also. When I was a kid, you know, I started playing because I saw Ringo on TV, and he played avidus Zildjian cymbals. But my grandfather happened to live around the corner from Fred Gretsch. And when I started playing the drums, I was at my grandfather's house on Long Island, Manhasset, Long Island. And he said, oh, you play drums? Well, I know my neighbor's Fred Gretsch. He makes drums. Let me call him. So Fred brought a bunch of drum catalogs over, these Gretsch catalogs. And in there, I saw this other variety of Zildjian cymbals, because Gretsch was the distributor of K Zildjian cymbals, which, you know, there's two lines to this family. One side came to America, that's the avidus side, and the K side stayed in Turkey. But Gretsch was the distributor for K Zildjian. And they had beautiful pictures in the catalog, but I didn't know anything about them, so I wasn't interested in them. And in fact, I wasn't really interested in the Gretsch drums either at that time, because Ringo played Ludwig. Anyway, fast forward, now I'm in college and I'm introduced to jazz and listening more to jazz. And it turns out that the jazz drummers I was listening to were playing these other Zildjians, these K Zildjians. So I became curious about them. One of my classmates, actually, he was a year older than me, was named Steve Wolkanowski. And he wanted to get some K Zildjians. He was a really good jazz drummer. So he took a journey from Denton, Texas to Chicago to Frank's drum shop to look for some K Zildjians. He told me when he got there, they had crates of cymbals that he had to open up. He opened up the crates and he brought two 20-inch K Zildjian cymbals home. And decided to sell one of them, which is this cymbal, which I bought from him, I think for $60. This is in 1973. And I played this cymbal for years. I played it with Woody Herman's band. It's the cymbal I'm playing, regardless of what it says, it's the cymbal I'm playing on the audio in the Art of Bop Drumming book. And these cymbals were kind of handmade, and this one, if you look at it carefully, it's got almost a bell like a mini cup. It's kind of small and flat and a little off-center. But the sound was more like the sound I was hearing on jazz records than the A Zildjian cymbals that I had at the time. So I was really happy to get this cymbal, and it sounds like this. I think it's a little cleaner than what most people would consider the old K sound. And on the bottom of it, there was a greenish, like postage stamp that said that this was a medium heavy cymbal. And this is a 20 inch, it weighs 2240 grams. But it's super clean. And has you know, a good part of the rainforest in it, which we like. I began assembling a collection of Ks because all my heroes were playing them at the time. And I've exchanged them through the years and tried to find more and more that really worked for me. I had a very thin 22-inch cymbal that I got a long time ago from a guy named Ned Ingbergman, who had a used drum business out of his mother's basement in Queens, New York, and I was living in Queens at the time. I got that cymbal, but it turned out it was too wild for me and too thin. So I was in a drum shop in New York. I forget which one it was, and I swapped that one for this 22, which I thought sounded like a really great A. So it's a little higher pitch than most people are accustomed to when they think of Ks, but it sounds like this. And I think either of these cymbals you can use in almost any musical situation. The pair of hi-hats I have here are actually not a pair. The bottom cymbal has the very old K Zildjian logo on it. It says Constantinople. So that means it was made, I'm assuming, before the city of Constantinople changed its name to Istanbul, which I think was in 1917. So that's a really old cymbal, and it was probably made for hand cymbals for concert band or orchestra. The top cymbal I bought from a good friend of all of ours named Jim Rupp, who runs Columbus Percussion. And I think they sound really good together. So these are just a couple of the cymbals I brought. I hope this gives you a reference point for tuning into that sound or some of the sound. There's so much range in the K Zildjian line because they were handmade. A lot of the cymbals that have survived are the best ones. There were a lot of dogs, and they seem to have disappeared. So I think these are some good ones to check out. I've got a couple more for you to hear. So we'll put them up and talk about them.